Hey there, in this quick tip video, I wanted to answer a couple of questions that were asked on the YouTubes. The first one was, can I edit guitar solos in Vari Audio? The second one that I saw was, can I edit harmonies in Vari Audio? Now the answer to those questions is yes and yes. You can edit any monophonic part, which includes guitar solos, and yes, you can edit harmony parts in Vari Audio inside of Cubase. So I thought I'd answer both questions with one video, except I'm not going to edit vocal harmonies. I'm going to edit guitar harmonies. The first thing I've done is come up to my main guitar part here. It's a guitar hook and it's just a simple melody. Now I've turned on Vari Audio and Vari Audio has analyzed this melody and it's given me a breakdown of all of the notes. And that's it there. So it's a descending melody and basically it's one of the main riffs or one of the main hooks in this song. So I'm going to copy and paste this melody down. Now that means I've got two melodies playing exactly the same thing, which isn't really what I want, but that's okay because on this second melody, I'm going to start editing this melody into a harmony. To do that, once I start moving on the first block, Cubase says, hey, you really want to create a new version of this. So I've selected new version, which means that the old version is stored. Now it's a matter of moving these parts around until I find something that sounds like it could be a harmony and it could work over the top of that main melody that I have as my hook. So I'm just picking up on these notes and I'm dragging them up and down. That's kind of working. I'm not really that keen or overly fussed on that first slide there. So I'm just stretching it out and I'm hovering around the bottom to get my scissors. And I'm going to put a nice little cut in here. So what I'm doing is breaking that note up into three notes. Now I've got all of my smart control options visible. So I basically hover my mouse around over these blocks and it gives me all of these different smart controls, including the scissors. Now when I move this block up, I can move it into the perfect position for a harmony. As I move it, I can hear the note being played and I can also see it on the piano scroll on the left-hand side. Okay, now I've got both of these guitar parts soloed and I'm just listening to see if they're the right notes. A lot of it is trial and error. Okay, that sounds much better. And the interesting thing is the timing's actually perfect because we've just copied that first part. So it's really quite a tight sound. And don't be put off by the actual sound as you're moving the notes because that's an unprocessed sound. It's not going through any of the effects. Another question someone asked was, can I see both the melody and the harmony or all of the harmonies? And you can just by highlighting them, double clicking, selecting Vari Audio and selecting Event. And now you can see the melody up above and the harmony that I'm creating down below. If need be, you can actually edit the note start point and the note end right here inside of Vari Audio, which is really cool if you're actually editing multiple harmonies which have been sung in and not copied and pasted, because you can get a really tight sound and you can match not just the pitch but also the timing up here inside of Vari Audio. Now it's a matter of just continuing on editing those harmony parts, and when you're finished, you can check it out in the track. Okay, I'm going for full ridiculous, and I'm going for a three-part harmony here. Now, as I start to move this, once again, Cubase will say, do you want to create a new version? Yes, yes, always create a new version, because you don't want to overwrite the main version, which, of course, is that melody. So once again, it's a matter of using my ears, trial and error. You'll know when it sounds bad because it will sound bad. But when it sounds good, it's really tight. If you want, you can have a mess around with the formant settings in Vari Audio. It's going to be hit and miss with a guitar part, but for example, let's just maybe solo this second guitar part here. So I'm just going to highlight it and then over here, let's solo it. Okay, now double click on it and you'll get the Vari Audio settings and let's change the formant over on the left hand side. And this is basically just messing with the tone a little bit. It's by no means the perfect pure guitar sound, but in a pop track, actually, it could be quite usable, and it could even be more of a synthesized guitar sound. In another section of this track, I've looped a guitar part and a guitar harmony. It's quite muted. But then I changed the verse chords, and rather than re-recording the guitar, I simply went into Vari Audio and I changed the notes to fit in with my new chord changes. And to be fair, I really couldn't tell the difference, and it was quite easy. It was just a matter of highlighting the parts that I wanted to change and using my mouse to drag them up and down until they fitted with the chords of my verse. There are so many cool applications for Vari Audio, and there's so many videos on the Cubase YouTube channel which show you how to use Vari Audio for a number of different applications. So, subscribe to the Cubase YouTube channel and give us the thumbs up if you've learned something. I'm going to catch you soon.